Welcome, guys, to the SAK Show, powered by Mac Coffee. Have you had yours? If not, go and grab it right away. If you're feeling hot, try out their iced coffee. That's pretty good. That's my current addiction. As for now, welcome to the show once again. Today's guest, the living legend, the one and only Apache India. He's just released a new album, and wow, it's pretty cool. It's making noise, and the song Trip to Jamaica has become massive. The guy's given us hits after hits after hits. Enjoy small snippets of his hits as we start the conversation with the one and only Apache India. Wind your body, wrinkle your belly, dip and go down in a new style. Wada dang dang, me are the don, me are the don Raja, me are the don, me are the don Raja, me are the don. Reggae chants man and the Indians, see me face up on the television, hear me voice on the radio station. Promoter them a come and them a rub off the man, man. Keep in a session and they want if it run. Put me name on the invitation. So the man himself, the living legend, Mr. Apache Indian. Wow, it's such a pleasure seeing you after a very long time, my brother.
Yeah, it's great to be with you. And you know, we're friends, go back a long, long time. So yeah, I've been missing you, missing the whole vibe. How's things out there in Kenya?
Kenya's pretty good, man. We're just surviving over here. And I can see that nice elephant in the background as well.
Yeah, I've been admiring all your pictures and all your wildlife and the elephants. I'm getting jealous here. I need to come back, Zach.
I promise you are coming down very, very soon, you know. Now, before you proceed, how's the COVID situation? Where are you right now, by the way?
I'm actually in Spain. I spent 6 months in a lockdown from March to August in the lockdown, recording my album, finishing my album. I came out here for a couple of weeks and, you know, we were trying to go back for October for the academy, for the college. Yeah. And the market hasn't opened up, not for musicians, not for the artists, no gigs, no academy, no college. So I thought I'll stay in Spain. I have a little place here. I actually finished my album out here then, September, October, released it in November. I'm only 2 hours away from home and I'm closer to you, right? So you tell me which way to go.
Nice. How's the COVID situation down there in Spain?
It's a big country, so it's scattered. Some parts are worse. Where I am, it's right in the south of Spain. There's no cases. It's a quiet village kind of place that I have right by the sea. It's just a shame how it's spreading and it keeps getting worse and good and bad. So, you know, it's very unpredictable. People don't know whether to go home or stay or go home for Christmas. And so it's just the uncertainty of it all. Is it safe? Is it not safe? When is the markets going to open? Yeah. Better to be safe than sorry. But, you know, this time of year, Diwali, Christmas, it's a tough one.
So once again, welcome to the show. And, you know, all your Kenyan fans over here, you know, we've seen you perform so many times. I remember the first time you came down, you know, it was the full band and everything. It was all the works and wow, those were the days. There were even some backing vocalists you had brought down and everything.
That's right. Kenya's been a special place. We go around the world. There's a couple of places that are special. Kenya is special. Kenya is different. There's always been love, and the way you guys work, you know, we can't even come to Kenya without seeing you. And you know, it's just the people that look after us so well. So thanks for that. Thanks to the fans. We've had some amazing concerts out there.
So 53 and still going strong, right?
That's right. 53 years young. You guys keep me young. The music keeps me young.
You know, it's like you're on the leagues of the Salman Khan and the Shah Rukh Khan. You know, even they are like that same age, but they, you know, they're just delivering more and more, and so are you.
Yeah, if the music wasn't good, I wouldn't be delivering it. But when I do it and it sounds good, it's to share with the world. So don't worry about the age. Start at any time and we'll carry on. We'll carry on to...
You know, amazing journey it's been so far, you know. I mean, wow, how let's start from the beginning. You know, we know that the No Reservations and all that, all the big tune. I remember, you know, my brother was a big fan of yours and he bought an EP. It just had like 3 songs and it was like, Make Way for the Indian, you know, and we were like, wow. And from there, Apache Indian, no stopping and everything. How's the journey been so far? And you know, what motivates you to still going so strong? And you know, we'll talk about your recent album as well. But how's the journey been so far, and your motivation?
I mean, the journey's been incredible. Everyone knows the music that I release is just a reflection of who I am, where I come from, reflection of Handsworth, Birmingham, reflection of my Indian roots, my love of reggae music. But Sak, I just want to take you a little bit further back to that, even before I got into music. When my parents came over from India, Punjab, Jalandhar in the 50s, 60s,
wow.
And they went straight to work in factories, and there was no school till 5. So I was dropped off the Jamaican nanny next door for Seriously? 8 hours a day for 5 years. So obviously an early exposure to culture, language, patois, food, music. Yeah, I never really, even acknowledged that part, because, I was always saying, I like reggae, Bob Marley, Bernie, Birmingham, and that was the obvious multicultural and everything, but really tracing it back. So where I say to people, it's not just reggae and he loves reggae, dreadlocks, whatever. I have an understanding of the culture, understanding of the language. So when I go to Jamaica and I've sang that song or reggae Sunsplash with the artists, the song's finished. What are you representing? How are you speaking? Do you know the culture, the language? So for me to be able to do that later on in life as Apache Indian, as an Indian, from Indian roots, it was because of those 5 years. Because, you can't just pretend to speak the language or, my respect and couple of, I understand it and I understand the culture. I have a great respect and love in Jamaica and friends and family. So why shouldn't I be a part of it? But I was a part of it as an Indian. So as soon as I released that first record, Apache Indian, movie of India, Chak De Don Raja, bursting. But sharing my life, my emotion, my culture, my multicultural, my Indian roots, my love of Jamaican music and culture. So a lot went into it before you even heard anything. That's why I'm still here. I'm enjoying that culture. The journey has been my life, my emotions, my anger, my sadness, from arranged marriage to Boom Shakalak to Om Namah Shivaya to Chak De. It's all there. It's not just one style of music. All my emotions, and the new album is similar again.
So the name Apache Indian, how did the word Apache come into it?
The Apache comes from Supercat, great reggae artist. I listened to him when I was a kid, still a friend of mine. So his name is Wild Apache from Jamaica, if anyone doesn't know, Jamaican born Indian. So Indian because I'm Indian. Right from day one, I wanted to put that, it's a statement, Apache Indian.
Who gave you that name? Somebody called you that and you just picked it up or what?
No. I actually, when I made my first record, they said, you have to fill in this form for the record company. I said, I only wanted to make one record. It didn't have a name. I didn't have a record label. I said, Movie of India is the name of the song. So what's your name? We need an artist name. I said, just for the sake of the form. Literally for the sake of the form. I said, Apache, I like Supercat. I'm Indian, Apache Indian. So it was literally that. And then, it stuck. I had more songs and it became, and people in America gave me a few problems. Apache Indian, no reservations. Are you Apache Indian? But all good. It's got a ring to it. It's become a household name. And, so takes me around the world.
Stephen Kapoor then became Apache Indian.
Stephen Kapoor, still Stephen Kapoor. Stephen VJ Kapoor. Originally from Jalandhar, Kapoor with a U-R, so I don't mind, Stephen with a V. And people say, your name's not Apache, you must be something. And I say, Stephen. They say, your name's not Stephen. Must be Sukhjinder or Sak or something. It's Surjit. So, I can't win, my name is Stephen. So there you go.
So let's talk about the inspiration, I mean, I know people who come, they do like one hit wonders, one album, big, massive, and then, well, so many artists have done it. There's no lies about that. But you see, bless you, you've come and you've conquered it. You're still conquering, and there's hit after hit, And let's talk about the motivation, inspiration. Where do you see all this?
Yeah, I mean, it's a good question. The motivation is life. It's always been life. I see something bad, I want to sing about it. I see something good, I want to celebrate it. Boom Shakalak, I'm celebrating life, I'm happy. Om Namah Shivaya was a time where, it's prayers and, I actually didn't even know what was going on. Sometimes music is heals me. Or sometimes, I wrote that song, Om Namah Shivaya, took it home from India. My father said to me, Stephen, how did you write this song? It's very different from Chak De, it's very different. I said, Dad, I don't know. It's very, slow song. Even in India when I was recording it, they said, what this guy's got? And the record company didn't like it, it's too religious. And I said, listen, I don't know where it came from. It's a prayer and I don't know. Anyway, I went home, my dad liked it. He goes, I'm going to love this song. Then I went to America a couple of weeks later and I came back and my father had passed away. Oh. So then if you look at that video, I made the video in India, I put his picture in the video. So really the prayer was said before it happened.
Wow.
So these are the kind of things I take from music, the emotion, the sharing of that. And that became a most requested song more than Boom Shakalaka, and it's healed many more people. So the, you know, the inspiration is those words from people. You know that song meant so much to me, and this changed my life, or it helped me, my community, or I was in a mixed marriage. You know, it's all these stories keep me going. But as I said, you know, the music is sharing my life, my emotions. If it wasn't good, I wouldn't release it. I keep it to myself. Sure. But people like it. It helps them, you know, celebrate life or heals them. Or you know, there's some great songs. I say that music changes people's lives. You can change all your emotions. And for me, because it was real. And you know, you talk about other people coming and going. Maybe it wasn't real. Maybe it wasn't for them. Maybe they're just copying somebody. I'm not hearing lyrics in songs like we used to. I'm not hearing meaningfulness. I'm hearing bali bali bling bling. Let's drive the car and let's sing and dance. It's great. There's an element of that. But what about the rest of it? You would never get that from Apache. You would never get one just happy, happy, happy. Because life's not like that. It's not like that. And so I express my feelings, my culture, my language as much as I can, sometimes straight up reggae, sometimes Punjabi as much as I can, push the culture, push the industry, and just try to use the platform to say good things. I'm not coming to you at 53 years old and say, Sak, tell everyone to buy my album. I'm telling you it's a platform to talk about COVID, talk about things in India, talk about, you know, whatever. Otherwise, what was it for, Sak? I mean, you're a DJ on the radio. You don't just come and promote yourself. You're talking to the community. You're talking to the people. You're, if something's bad, you want to talk about it. If something's good, you want to celebrate it. And that's what I do with music.
So do you feel that your music has also evolved through time from where it was and where it is now? You know, maybe
yes, definitely, because, you know,
completely... more for the masters and entertainment, but now it's become more personal.
Yeah, I mean, they say that, you know, your first album is, you have your whole life to do it. Yeah. So it's all your thoughts, all your vibes, all your sounds. So, you know, arrange, No Reservations was arranged, marriage, drink problems, alcohol. I mean, it was AIDS problems, caste problems, everything. I was bursting with these things. Then the album took me around the world. So then, you know, I want to pick up Tim Dog, Make Way for the Indian, Ragamuffin Girl, Frankie Paul in Jamaica, Asha Bose, Aya Rahman in India. So I'm enjoying myself around the world, enjoying that thing that I had. I'm sharing with people. People are sharing with me different languages, from Telugu to Tamil to whatever it may be, you know, learning more Hindi. So, and then, you know, you go through the journey over the years, sometimes experimental music. But I think I've come back around in a circle. This album is my favorite album. I don't know why this is my favorite album. What's not to love? It has all the Punjabi, the Hindi, it has all the things I love, the reggae, it has the spirit in a song called Stronger, another great song called How Long. I'm working with people around the world. So it's about the caring, the sharing, the platform. And what are you doing and saying as an artist? What's the substance? What's your identity? What are you representing? That's what's missing from the industry. What are you representing as a person? What are you saying?
You know, What's Not to Love, I heard it last night and I was like, wow, it's something different. And, you know, I was like, my favorite song actually is Angelina. I just love that one.
Oh,
you know, I was like, whoa, that's a big deal. And I think I even
tried to see.
Like, whoa, you, that's a
big you know your music, Zach. I know that, yeah, for years. Yeah. And I'm glad you picked that song. It's a great song. It's fresh. It's actually with a young new Asian producer from London called Jay Productions. He's the only guy that's got three songs on the album. You know, I met Jay a couple of years ago and he was so disheartened. There's no help. His family help him, but no support. There's no Indian in his songs. But so where does he go?
Yeah.
What's his platform? So he gave up because Pacha finished. Since that time, I got him back up. He's helping the academy. He released songs with other artists that have been on
Radio
1.
So he's part of your academy?
He's a part of my academy, but he lives in London. But he released songs that went onto Radio 1 since that time.
Wow.
So it just shows that we have to help people. We have to give them a chance. We have to inspire them. There's talent out there, but we have to do more in the Asian community. You know, all these TV channels we have, it's not for just Bollywood and Hindi, is it?
It's for
the young, urban
art.
And if you look at the channels, you know, in the UK TV channels, there's not one channel you can go on to sing a song or live music, Krishna, nothing. It's all the serials, it's all this, it's all that. Times have to change now because the industry is suffering. People like that are suffering. But yeah, great song. That one, a Spanish collaboration called Ay Papi that he did with a Spanish girl, beautiful. And a song called Stronger. He did those three strong songs. Very, very, very talented.
The sound is so fresh. I just love it.
Yeah. Yeah, fresh, new ragaton. You know, as an artist, you have to, you know, you have to look after your orders, but you have to come new, you have to come fresh. And that's the best. I love that you picked that song.
I hope you're doing a video for that, by the way.
Yeah, we're going to do a video for that, but obviously the markets are shut and you don't want to get to Puerto Rico. And if, so even this single trip to Jamaica, we was on the way to Jamaica to make that video. Obviously, we haven't made it. We made an animated video.
I saw that. So that's pretty cool.
I'm going to post it up today. So yeah, we're trying our best. It's difficult. No gigs, no videos. We need support from the radios. Come on.
I mean, trip to Jamaica is playing everywhere, even in Kenya, all over the world, guys. Here, just listen to a small snippet of this track, and then we continue our conversation with AZ.
In Atlantic, Java to Jamaica, you can bring your friends, Tisha and Zuleika. I'll party in the Caribbean, Sony, and play some reggae music in a Montego rain. In Atlantic, Java to Jamaica, you can bring your friends, Tisha and Zuleika. I'll party in the Caribbean, Sony, and play some reggae music in a Montego rain.
So let me take you, sweet girl, we don't know more. Can't you tell me that you love me more when we there?
So guys, that's the song with Hunters. How did you collaborate with Hunters? I mean, I know the guy is a very talented person.
Yeah, very, very talented guy. His whole family, Ishus, V, big shout out to everyone. Hunters moved to Birmingham recently and he started coming to my academy. And he started helping the young people. If people don't know, I have an academy.
Yeah, let's talk about the academy, please. What is this?
7 years.
I saw your documentary. That was like, wow, you know. It touched a spot. Tell us more about
that. Thank you very much. I mean, Saki, in a way, throughout my life and career, I've questioned with God, what was it all for? You know, Gio, what is it? Fame, money, music. I'm not that person. There was something missing. I literally, throughout my whole career, there was in my private meditation time, I just say, what is it? There must be something more. So you don't write songs like Arranged Marriage thinking of the charts or fame. You just this is my feeling and my emotion. So anyway, 7 years ago, I decided to give up a day of my week, Wednesday, I set up a youth club in Handsworth, where I was born, in a college. So the college, meaning that we use the resources of the place that we have, not ask anyone for money, no funding, no nothing. Let me just go in there as a human being and help my community. The kids started walking in one by one, in a studio, life skills, help them get jobs, whatever it may be, get them back into education, you know, even just make a call to an uncle and say, give the girl a chance, you'll be good at as a care worker, or whatever it may be in a shop. The personal touch that we used to have. If it wasn't for youth clubs, I wouldn't be here. You know, the love from the community, cohesion. Everyone talks about cuts and, you know, we've got no money. Well, when you got no money, you think out the box, you use what you have.
True.
So the college worked, the concept worked. I went out and asked people for help. Someone gives me 3,000 bottles of water every year from London. Somebody gives me food, East End Foods give me food every 2 weeks. So it's the best thing I did in my life. It's made sense of my career. It's 7 years. I have now an academy in Holland. So the AIM Academy Holland, AIM Academy Birmingham. The next one will be India. I would love to set one up in Kenya.
Awesome.
Just to find a place where kids can come. I will fly in every month, my own expenses. Come and see them, come and help them. You know, all free studio time, or it doesn't matter what nationality. And that's the other thing, Zach. You know, communities are becoming more diverse. And diversity is great. We celebrate, you know, diversity, but it could be a problem on the streets. Yeah. Gangs, people from different areas. We don't know you, Gale, Bile, but the piece of Eastern Europe, Africa, it's not a problem. It could be a problem. And then music brings them together. So in my academy, I have people from all over the world. And then now they're meeting people from Handsworth and from Birmingham and we're getting on. So it does a lot more than music. It helps the community. We help the police. We help the hospitals. Anywhere we can raise money, we do it. So look out for AIM, Apache Indian Music Academy, on Instagram, on Twitter. Help us. We don't need any money. Just show some love, show some support. And it may be coming to a city near you. You know, like Zach, we've worked together for over 20 years.
Yeah.
And this is my friends coming together and saying, let's do that in Kenya. Apache's going to come over. We've got resources. We've got family. We've got friends. And it helps the next generation. Otherwise, what was it for? So look out for that. Follow me at Apache Indian HQ There's a lot more information. Remember, I can't come here and just say buy my next single. It represents the Academy, it represents my life.
Much more than
so
that.
Helping people. We were on the BBC One show. This, you probably saw that piece, yeah. 5 minutes on the BBC. I mean, incredible. And so they asked me, come on, Patchy, 30 years, boom, shakalak, we want to celebrate. And I says, yeah, fine, but come and film the kids. Come and film the college. Come and film the community. And how many more smiling faces do you have? And that's the effort I'm talking about, that one extra step to help and care and share. And that's what we're here for. What else was it for? What else is music for? It's not just to dance and,
true, true.
What else is radio for? It's to come together, and together we make a difference. So
would you say
and then,
this is your ultimate goal now?
It's my ultimate goal, as well as music, but you know, it keeps me going. It keeps, you know, the bigger the music is, the more popular the Academy is. You know, if I got a song at number one, oh, let's go and join Apache's Academy. So the drive is not just music. Obviously, it's my life. I love music. But when you're talking about something so passionately, about community, about knife and gun crime, cult, you know, whatever it may be, if you're so passionate, then I'm now more passionate to want to do something as well as just talk about it. Time for action. Action speaks louder than words. Otherwise, why did I speak about it? So I'm passionate enough to now go and do something about it. I don't want any advertising and promotion for the things I'm doing to help the kids. I just want you to know, people to know, it was always a movement, no reservation, started the movement, time for change, make way for the Indian. Yeah. The title itself has a meaning. So now I'm gonna come and say it straight. You know, it's we have to help people. I've said it from day one. I've never said anything different, especially our own culture. We have our own issues in our own culture. We don't support each other enough. We all got the egg, he got the Hakim, he's not doing that. Hakim, he's better than him. The fight is not our own culture, the fight's against the world. Let's get on those global stages. Let's help our community. And that's what I'm about, Zach. I'm all about that. I'm all about that.
I think you should consider politics, man.
I mean, I don't like politics, but I like politics because it's people deciding our lives.
Yes.
You know what I mean? And people have asked me to go into politics. But more movement from the street. The politicians have got it wrong. They don't know what they're doing. Look in America. There's been an absolute disgrace for 4 years.
True.
I mean, they should not allow, the lesson they should learn, don't allow people in politics who have got money, just money. In England, you can't do that. You have to be a councillor, MP, you have to go through the system, you have to learn. So how can you be a doctor without going to school, without going to college? This guy's gone straight in, he's saying stupid things. You know, the American dream went out the window, not very bright, but could be a great businessman, but not a politician. So he's gone. The UK, they're making decisions. You know, they made decisions before, and we lost money, we lost jobs. We're making decisions now, we lost lives. So who's listening to who? We need to listen to our own hearts and soul, pray to God. No man can rule us. You can see they're making mistakes. So music has always been said that from music you will see change. The singers and writers will bring change on this world. So, and music has been powerful like that in history. So where are we, guys? What are we saying? What are we doing? Are we coming together? And if not, when? When are we going to help each other? Look what's happened. When are we going to stand together? When are we going to be speaking? So this is what this album's about. I will speak to people about the album, but you know what? We haven't even come onto the album. Look how many things we've got to talk about.
Sure. So much. I mean,
serious things. And let's go back to Hunter. Hunter started helping me with the Academy. He's so talented. He'll pick up a bass guitar and teach you, pick up a double and teach you, he'll start teaching, all free of charge, the kids love him. And then he started speaking to me about this collab, he sent me this trip to Jamaica, I fell over. I thought, wow, great chorus. Look at the chorus, Denuma Lajama to Jamaica, you know what I mean? If you don't understand Punjabi, you understand the chorus.
True.
How's that? You know what I mean? Bring your friend's t-shirt and Zuleika. And you know, he had me under pressure, I had to give him some special verses. He loved my verses. I love the thing. I mean, it sounds fresh. Everybody loves it. It's been played in Jamaica. It's played on all the reggae stations and the Indian stations. So it's already crossed over. So lovely, lovely. Hope you guys like it out there.
You know what I love about you is the fact that, you know, artists are like, oh, albums don't work. We got to do singles, this, that. They've got a reason to release their music because they are thinking commercially. But I guess you're looking at a bigger picture and you're like, you know, let's spread the word out.
I mean, why an album? Album is like 9 singles, but really, Apache Indian can't keep everybody happy with one song. If I told you now after COVID, after everything, I'm saying, let's take a trip to Jamaica. it doesn't make sense. But if I'm telling you, let's take a trip to Jamaica, and then I'm telling you, you know, we have Binda Bajwa, then we have Angeline, and then we have Stronger. I want to feel stronger each day. My faith, it leads the way to a place where I will pray and give thanks for life, I say. You know, then you get the whole emotion, happy, sad, conscious, angry, you know, everything in one. And that's what an album does for me. So come on, people. And my audience are so diverse. Yeah. So why don't people release albums? There's just excuses. You know, release music.
That brings me to the next question. How do you find that balance over here? You know, because Apache Indian is like, as you said, your audience is diverse. You know, you've got the Indians to please as well, you know, our people. And then, you know, you've got the other side as well. How do you find that perfect balance in between them?
It's just, you know, it's just about finding the balance in the music. Like Angelina, it's not Indian, it's not reggae, it's new. So you don't always have to wave the Indian flag. I'm a reggae artist. Some of my reggae fans only want to hear straight reggae. They don't want to hear the tabla. They don't want to hear the Punjabi. I mean, the reggae audience, and sometimes they switch off. And same the other side, some of the Asian audiences don't want to hear the hardcore. So I really have to tailor it. But I make it all minor, make it all real. And everyone's happy. Everyone's happy. And look what you've got there. You've got Punjabi, you've got Hindi, you've got hip hop, you've got reggae, you've got India, you've got Canada, you've got UK. But yet it just seems like Apache Indian, just, you know, yeah. It's so much effort. So enjoy it. But there's so much work and effort and, you know, getting the balance right and pleasing so much people. But it works. It works, especially with this album in its entirety. So listen to all of it, people, and, you know, have it met. You know, enjoy it, because I think that, as I said, it's my best album, What's Not to Love. And I wouldn't be releasing music right now unless it was sounding the way it was. And, you know, as I said, on my Instagram, I have every single person who's involved with the album doing a shout out. So yeah. It's the care, it's the share. I have people, legendary, like Hunters, but then I have an artist like John Rogers from my academy, who's never released a song, called Together as One. And Together as One, summing up what's happening around the world, the Black Lives Movement in America. So it's all there, cleverly written. And, you know, a few lines in there were very special. But I can't just, you know, as I said, can't just do, from Trip to Jamaica to Together as One to, yeah, you know, Feeling Stronger. And then you have my full Apache Indian package and my full emotions, yeah, across the spectrum.
Wow. I mean, beautiful, man. By the way, I mean, you know, I love the fact that you're actually going behind and promoting the producers as well, and, you know, not just taking all the credit as an artist, you're giving the credit.
Yeah. Even the mixer, the guy who mastered it behind the scenes, even the musicians, the bass player, the saxophone player, everybody is on there. So that's what I'm, you know, I'm trying to be inspired. I'm trying to inspire the musicians out there. It's not just you, you know, it takes, there's a team behind it. Even when you do a radio show, there's a team. Sure. And then when I go on the road, I have 14, 15 musicians and engineers and all that. So everyone's suffering right now as well. But, you know, regardless of the situation, I always promote my team. And there's, as I said, there's 25 people involved with this album. Everyone's there. And let's care, let's share. Music brings us together, and together we bring changes. So don't leave out anybody, guys.
There you go, guys. You're listening it from the man himself, the living legend, Apache Indian. So any parting words to all your Kenyan fans, and also any advice to all the people who are struggling right now, and also the ones who want to come up musically?
Yeah, for all the Kenyan fans, I love you. I mean, I've been coming there for years. This week, I've done an interview to Cape Town, to Zambia, now I'm so happy with Kenya. I wish we get more support from Kenya. I wish we can get more support from Kenya FM. Are these stations still running?
Yeah, they're running. We'll push it up.
You gotta help me promote them. Send it out to everyone, because I represent more than just the music, you know, the academy. Look out for the BBC show, everyone, Apache Indian BBC One show, with all the kids. We have a big TV commercial running here. I don't know whether anyone's told you, for Lynx, you know, the spray.
Yeah.
So it's been running for 8 months here with Anthony Joshua, the big boxer, and he's playing Boom Shakalak.
Boom Shakalak.
So,
right? Yeah.
Yeah. So I'm in everyone's homes and bedrooms and living rooms 10 times a day on every channel, the longest running TV commercial playing reggae music by an Indian artist in this country. Wow. Still running.
Wow.
Still running. I'll send it to you after this. Okay. But Anthony Joshua, AJ Tracy, some big rappers, some big people in there. So look at that, you know, celebrating 30 years with that, celebrating 30 years with the Academy, celebrating 30 years with a great new album, and celebrating 30 years talking about things that matter. I would love to come back to Kenya. I can only come back with you, Zach. So you tell me when that market's going to open up, and let's do it. Let's do it. Let's talk. We're always friends. We're always in touch. But, you know, this time I'm going to be bothering you. I'm going to keep in touch with you. I'm not going to wait for the next album. Let's do something to help the kids. Let's do something in Kenya. You know, Kenya's given me so much love. I want to give love back. If we can set up something, let's do it. Even once a month, once every 2 months. If we start something, it will grow. So you have my love. You have my support. Okay. I'm coming over to see you guys. Thank you, Kenya. Thank you, Africa. Especially Kenya and these places. When I come, the diversity and how it brings people together. You know, Zach, I've been asked to go and do reggae shows in places where probably Indian people don't go. True. And I've told people, Indian, you got to come here. And they see me on stage and Indian people come in there and the rest of it's black. So music breaks down these barriers. Music brings us together. Artists, please make your music represent more. Don't just do it because, you know, music is not worth any money anymore. So what's it for? It's for the live show. It's for the interaction. It's for the fans. And it's for what you're saying and what you're representing. I can only thank you enough, Zach. Thank you to you. Thank you to your station. Thank you for reaching out. And we've done this interview and it hasn't even come through record company or PR management. It's come through friendship.
That means
a lot to me. Oh, we'll say thank you to everybody in Kenya awesome. For me. You know, anything that we can do to support, I'm coming back soon.
Wow, some great insights over here from the living legend, Apache Indian. Thank you so much for your time, and all of you, thank you so much for watching. Please do subscribe to the channel, it means a lot. And thanks for watching the SAK Show, powered by Mac Coffee, only on Zumbi TV.